Hi there. Welcome to our Jogit DX Getting Started video guide. Let's start off with the Jogit App Center. Here we can see the Jogit App Center, which displays a grid of apps. These sample apps are available in the default Jogit DX installation, along with several sample Jogit users we can try out. Now, we will log into the Jogit platform as one of the sample users, named Kat Grant. Click on the login link on the top right of the App Center. Kat Grant's username is Kat, and his password is password. Alright. We have successfully logged in as Kat. Each distinct user may have different levels of privileges for different apps, depending on its configured permission. Now, let's try out one of the sample apps here. Click on the Expenses Claims app. Do note that apps will always open in a new browser tab. Starting with the basics, a Jogit app consists of four basic elements: form, data list, process, and user view. We will briefly show you all of these in a moment. Right here, we can see the front-end UI of the Expenses Claims app. This is called a user view. An app may contain one or more user views. User views can have different themes, and consist of menu pages that contain forms, lists, reports, HTML contents, and more. Click on the Create a New Expense Claim button to see an expense claim form. A form can contain many form elements, and is used to capture user input and display information. There are plenty of form elements available in Jogit, ranging from a simple text field, up to complex elements, such as multiple select box, spreadsheet, and so forth. Let's fill in the expense claim form. In this form, let's select the user Clark Kent as the approver. Once you are done, click on Complete to submit this form. Now that we have submitted an expense claim in the perspective of an end user, now we will explore the user view in the perspective of our previously nominated approver, Clark Kent. We will now log out as Kat, and log in as the approver, Clark. Clark Kent's username is Clark, and his password is password. Great job so far. Now click on the Approver Inbox menu, in the Approver List category. In this page, we can see a list of tasks for the current user Clark, along with several useful information in a glance. What we are seeing here is called a data list. The data list is defined as a table for displaying records in a tabular format, typically used for reporting purposes. The data list has features such as paging, sorting, filtering, and exporting. In this case, Clark will see a pending expense claim previously submitted by Kat. This shows that a workflow process, or a form of orchestration is in action, where a task is routed to the appropriate person. This is called a process. Now as the user Clark, click on the HOD approve link to start approving Kat Grant's submission. And that's it. We have successfully approved the expense claim. The Expenses Claims app demonstrates a process-driven app. The process may also involve integration to external systems, such as sending emails, updating external databases, and so much more. Alright. We are done with the short introduction of Jogit DX. To find out more about Jogit, you can head to our Jogit knowledge base to explore its features. Thanks for watching.